drop kick, so they'll bounce. Ambitious pass, trying to play that past two Hearts players. Offside decision has been acknowledged by the referee. Here's Weir. Miller has found space again. Well, that was intended for Gascoigne, but miscued by Miller. So 3 minutes plus stoppage time. The time when Andy Gorham had treatments, we added to this, so still time for Hearts. Strong challenge by Robertson. Here's Mackay. Robertson. Mackay. Tackle came from Robertson. No question, that's a good pass back. Is now Neil McCann, thoroughly deserved the award. Here he goes again. Fulton. Well read by Goff. Quick reactions in defence. Gascoigne. It's away from Pasquale Bruno. Faced now by Poynton. Miller. Loudrum on the outside. Vicious that to Miller with Loudrum in such good position to him, the right-hand side. That's Fulton. It's easily mopped up by Robertson. Well, the whistle is gone. Robertson seemed to have the advantage there. Walter Smith checks how long to go. Only a minute and a half plus injury time. First trophy of the season appears to be safely tucked away now. Hard earned though, Hearts made sure that. Such a spirited comeback after a disastrous start. That's a good ball that from Gorham to Robertson. Here's Alberts, eased out of that by Mackay. Headed away by Bjorklund. Space again for Gascoigne. Looks up to assess the options, retains possession. The gap opens up, that's for McCoist. Well, how Gascoigne found McCoist in that position was quite remarkable. There was really no way through to McCoist, it appeared. Gascoigne found it.
He's got tremendous ability and he knows exactly where the position of other players is, and that beautiful reverse pass found McCoist, and Alan Benoit didn't do better.
Here's David Weir for Hearts, another who's played very well in the match. Well by Bjorklund, surely, yes, the free kick's been given, and Bjorklund is going to be booked. He did hold them quite deliberately there. So a late opportunity here for Hearts from the set piece. Gorham lines up the shot, two-man wall. McCann, I'm sure, will not attempt a shot at goal here. He'll be looking for one of his teammates in the middle. Just like that. It's scored by David Weir. Time running out for Hearts. But they're back within a goal, Rangers. The Rangers defence caught napping. David Weir scores. Well, really, McCann's free kick to pose a problem all night long. But look at the space that David Weir's got in there. And really, Andy Gorham's entitled to ask questions of his defence here. But all credit to Hearts, they've made a real game of this. Well, now, time the enemy for Hearts. We're into stoppage time now. Well into stoppage time, can Hearts produce a total miracle here? Here comes Fulton. Now Weir. Mackay, they have to have the ball played forward quickly.
McCoist is back, track to point and do some marking. Cameron. Dumped away by Gore. The referee checking his watch regularly here. The Rangers supporters anxious and waiting for this final whistle. What a contribution Hearts have made to the final. Bjorklund's header, that's Robertson. Returned by Bruno, and up and under. Goff wins it for Rangers. Moore plays that up the line. The referee brings the game to an end. Rangers have won the Coca-Cola Cup. It's been a dramatic final all the way. Neil McCann congratulated there by Ali McCoist. Swarthmore strips contemplated Paul Gascoigne. Won the game in the end for Rangers with two splendid second half goals after Hearts had come back from the two goals scored by McCoist in the first half through Steve Fulton and John Robertson. It's been a marvellous final. Hearts have contributed hugely, but Rangers had the genius in the end of Gascoigne. Andy Gorham was a hero. Several fine saves in key moments. No chance with any of the goals. Greeting Pasquale Bruno there. Well, the Rangers supporters had to breathe uneasily for some time in that match. But in the end, the first major trophy of the season goes back to Ibrox after a three-year gap. And the presentation ceremony being prepared here. But the congratulations among the Rangers players going on. Jim Jeffries shaking hands with all his players as well he might. They've given him everything. And they certainly have made up for the cup final they've been in May with a great effort. And he's complaining there, Jim Jeffries, to Jude Allis. Well, there's a debate going on, Jude Allis and Jim Jeffries, about a goal Rangers score. Paul Ritchie, that marking role, and Brian Lowdrop, he stuck the task very well indeed. But Gascoigne came back to haunt Hearts. Gary Mackay, irate about something. What he wants to do, I don't know. Complaining about something. Well, Hearts' passions are high here. So, Walter Smith is with his 11.
Delighted to have won. Felt it was a very good game and one that everybody that took part can be proud of.
At 2-0 it was shades almost of May. Were you guilty of perhaps taking your foot a wee bit off the pedal at that point?
I think I've got to give Hearts a bit of credit. We started the game very well, played very well the first half hour. Hearts had the best of the next half hour of the game, played very well indeed. And after that Paul Gascoigne got two quick goals, which took a bit of stopping out of them, but credit to them. They came back, scored in the late in the game, and it was a terrific cup tie. Very well, a spell in the game, and two terrific goals from her.
Right until the end, they made it very tight. What was your blood pressure doing at the end of
the
game?
It was well up. It was well up long before then.
Congratulations.
So a very happy Rangers manager Walter Smith. It's his 11th trophy as Rangers manager. It's a remarkable record. Still a bit of aggravation down there on the Hearts players. Not sure what all that's about. Jim Jeffries having worse still with the referee. Well, I'm not sure what's upset Jim Jeffries so much, but he's having a fair old go at the referee. Presentation now for the Hearts players, the losing side going up. The presentation being made by Charles Brock, operational marketing director at Coca-Cola UK.
You talking to him?
And the Hearts supporters reflect their feelings about their team. They've been served proudly by the Hearts team this afternoon, and they're showing their appreciation. Colin Cameron getting a loser's medal that the winners he got with Raith Rovers 2 years ago. Neil Craig, the league president on the left. Peter Bonham, the league secretary on the right. Charles Brock in the middle. Jeremy Gosk is through, substitute not used by Hearts. And now the match officials go forward. The Hearts supporters and the Rangers supporters in unison. Giving a bit of stick to Hugh Dallas, but over the piece, handled the game well. Dougie Main from Bonnybridge and Alan Freeland from Aberdeen, the match officials. Jim McCluskey, the fourth official. Now the moment for the Rangers supporters. Presentation ceremony for the Coca-Cola Cup. Walter Smith hugely relaxed now, Archie Knox too. Wasn't always like that in the match though. So Richard Gough on that familiar path to collect the trophy. Done it so many times as Rangers captain. He goes to do it again. Trophy held aloft to the Rangers fans. Andy Gorham, who made a big contribution for Rangers despite losing three goals, a number of excellent saves. Brian Laudrup still managed to cause problems despite the man-marking job done so well by Paul Ritchie. Charlie Miller, the 20-year-old, youngest player on the side. David Robertson went through this with many times for Rangers and for Aberdeen before that. George Alberts gets his first trophy in Scottish football. The same for Joachim Björklund, the Swede. Craig Moore, the young Australian. And Paul Gascoigne gets a terrific ovation for a marvellous performance capped by two magnificent goals. Harry McCoy's the same. Forgot to collect his medal, Paul Gascoigne. No such forgetfulness from Ali McCoist. And Gordon Petridge, who won a cup for his medal with Dundee United against Rangers in 1994. Alec Cleland, who was off at half-time. Just Elders coming through there. Peter Van Bossen. What a terrific atmosphere still inside Celtic Park after this marvellous cup final. So the lap of honour will perhaps be carried out, but after the photograph session. It's a terrific setting this now at Celtic Park for a big match. 50,000 people here. No one has left the ground, I would suspect. Not even Heart supporters, because they have everything to be proud of in their team's performance. So, Rangers, Coca-Cola Cup winners of 1996. You'll see these pictures in the papers in the morning. Richard Gough wants to end his career at Rangers with a treble. The first leg has been achieved successfully. Andy Gorham peering to the crowd looking for someone he knows. Ali McCoist is with Hazel.
Oh, I'm pleased. Hearts made this battle all the way. Credit to them, they came back with 2-0 down. I thought they were there. They made this battle, but it's just a magic feeling, magic feeling.
How shocked were you when they made it 2-2?
Well, I knew they would come out at us in the second half. And I don't know what to put in me McCann's tea at half-time, but I could do with something like that. And to their credit, they scored a good goal through Robbo, but Gascoigne's second goal was superb.
Your first goal, lovely neat interplay with Brian Laudrup.
Laudrup's, you're always going to get chances like that with Laudrup, because he plays lovely football. And it's just a matter of getting yourself, make yourself available for him, and thankfully it went in.
The second one ahead of
him? Unlike me, I know. I normally wear hats like yours in the box. And thankfully I got my header, I think it was a Craig Moore header, and knocked it in, I'm pleased.
Congratulations, enjoy your night.
Thanks very much, all the Hazel.
Well, Walter Smith and Richard Gough have been together for so many years in their joint careers. Paul Gascoigne savouring the moment here. Archie Knox there also, the assistant manager, out with the players. Well, there are interviews going on there, radio reporters on the pitch as well. Photographers everywhere. for this game only passed an inspection 1 hour before the start, and what a treat we would have missed had it been postponed till Wednesday night when it would have been due to be replayed. The Rangers fans staying to show their appreciation for this terrific match and the performance of the winning side. Ali McCoist always quick to snatch the headgear, respond to the crowd. Well, Hearts end of the ground emptying now slowly, the Rangers fans staying in numbers. Miserable winter's afternoon, but that's all being forgotten in the context of a marvellous final. The pitch certainly proved to be absolutely ideal for the occasion, despite the snow and the sleet. And Walter Smith continuing his incredible record as Rangers manager. 11 trophies since April 1990, one not including the championship won that season. Got him there, blinding Davy Dodds. Despite the success of the years before, these Rangers players clearly enjoying this to the full again. What a terrific key to the football this is now. Well, the man who won the game for Rangers was Paul Gascoigne.
Paul, fantastic. Two goals, you really lifted the cup final today.
It was good all-round team performance. The lads defending well, but Hearts deserved the 3 goals. It was just good that we got 4.
In a personal sense, it's come at a terrific time for you, this push.
Yeah, well, you know, I've still got all the problems at the sort of, but everything's come along nicely, hopefully, and I think it's not improved my game the way I used to play.
What about the backing of the band?
Fantastic, fun, brilliant. This is what it's all about, the Rangers.
Gascoigne anxious to rejoin his teammates with the trophy. No matter how much success these players enjoy, every trophy means something. This one clearly means a great deal to these players. It means the treble is on, and that is always the target at the start of the season.
We made things very difficult for ourselves there today, but I'm disappointed with the way we played, because we never played really well, but I'd rather be disappointed with the way we played and still have won the trophy than have played well and not won at all.
How much credit do the Hearts deserve coming back at you in that way?
They played very well. I think, looking at the game from where I was, Amos probably had the two outstanding players on the field.